So the other day I was thinking of a video to make, and I didn't want to make something that was like completely about music. So I was thinking like what goes hand in hand with like music, specifically like rap. And then I thought basketball, 'cause niggas in the NBA want to be rappers and rappers want to be niggas in the NBA. So I think they just go hand in hand with each other. So in today's video, I'm going to be basically comparing NBA players to rappers. Like this is their counterpart of the music industry. And probably name like seven people, eight people. And yeah, that's it. This is going to be current NBA players, by the way. So I'll do like an all-time if this gets a lot of views. Like this does like decent. I'm talking like 300, like 700. I'll do all-time for y'all niggas. And I feel like the most obvious is Drake and LeBron. This is not only because they're close friends or anything, but because they both been doing their professions for so long. And it seems like as they go on with their careers, people tend to hate on them more, and it's like a popular thing to hate on them. But these are people that no one can deny their accomplishments. Drake has, I think, like the most like number ones by a male artist right now, like alive. No offense to my nigga Michael Jackson. And LeBron has the most points, active points from a NBA player. Like they just go hand in hand with each other. I don't think Drake's the greatest rapper. Like I think LeBron's the greatest NBA player, but he definitely has an argument for it if you're comparing what he's done accomplishments wise and number wise. But yeah, these are just people who have been doing this shit for long as I've been alive. Shit, past when I've been alive. Drake blew up. LeBron was drafted 2003. Drake blew up really like 2009. So yeah, like pretty much my whole lifetime they've been doing this. And they're both just really good at their craft. And yeah, we need to give them their flowers for both of them. We have two of the most polarizing figures of their respective careers. We have the most polarizing and disrespected modern NBA player in Kevin Durant. And even more polarizing and disrespected artists in Kanye West, or now Ye. Two men raised by their strong black mothers, which is why I guess you could say they're real vocal, and some could say sensitive, but I think they're just real vocal
There's
about
nothing
how
you're
real
saying
about how
has
they want to express
anything to
themselves
do
in ways.
with regret.
They both feel they're held to unfair standards, and they neither of them really can take criticism well. But when you're as good as them, it kind of makes sense. I mean, they back themselves up for the most part. Kevin Durant is one of the greatest scorers of all time. Kanye West is one of the greatest artists of all time. And their fans really love them, and their haters really, really, really hate them. And some will say they miss the old Kevin Durant, the old Kanye, like from this, and this is like 10 years ago. They don't really like that they've changed from what they used to be 10, 15 years ago. But yeah, these are people who have been doing this for a minute. They're really great at it. They're not as good as they used to be, obviously. It comes with age, but they're still really, they've been consistently the greatest in their respective careers. Kanye is the only artist to have a number one in three different decades. Kevin Durant just moved up to the top eight in scoring, and this is while missing, I think, like pretty much basically like three seasons for real. He's really missed three whole seasons, and he's still top eight in scoring. And he's been roughly averaging 27 the past 5 seasons, even after an Achilles injury, which is a career-ending injury. This one sucks, but it's really short. Lonzo Ball and Chance the Rapper, two niggas that we don't really see do what they're known supposedly for doing. Like, I haven't heard about Chance the Rapper rapping in probably about like 3 years. Lonzo Ball hasn't played basketball in probably about like 2 years now, but 2 years, that's like 3 seasons for real in the NBA. So he hasn't played since 2000, what, like 22. And yeah, Chance the Rapper, I don't, and the thing is this, like, it's not their fault. Like, they rose really high when they were younger. Like, they were at the top of the world, like, I'd say like 6 years ago. UCLA, Chino Hills, Lonzo Ball, that was that nigga. Like, even though his LeVar had him fucked up saying he was gonna be better than Michael Jordan and all this other shit, he was still that nigga at the time. Chance the Rapper, when he dropped that shit, Acid Rain, bro, when he had no problems, shit like that. And the thing is with Chance, I don't think you should fall off just because of one bad album. But that's just me. And Lonzo Ball, he was steadily increasing, and then just something happened with his knee. Something's always wrong with them ball niggas. But yeah, it's just two people who just fell off the face of the earth. Hopefully, they could both make comebacks though. So yeah.
But they worked it out.
This one's another one that I feel is really easy to compare. We have two people who are kind of odd, quiet, and you don't really know how they act when they're not on the like camera. Like, I don't think they act how they do on camera, like at home. But they're two people who have been, actually doing their professions for quite a long time. Like, Kawhi's been in the league since, like, I think 2011. Been doing this 14 years. Cardi started rapping 2012. They've been really, you know, doing this for a long time, and it doesn't feel like they're that old, or they've been doing it for as long as they have. But, you know, they're people who don't make that many appearances, but when they do, they really show out. Kawhi Leonard really in the playoffs, especially. He's one of the greatest playoff performers in the modern day NBA. And Cardi is someone who is literally just garners so much attention with everything he does, whether that's, you know, questionable or not. But someone who attracts attention either way. And with that is the end of part one. I'll probably do a part two, depending on how much it is. Well, no, I'll probably just do a part two just to do it with all time or more current, because I didn't even get on my favorite player. Let me say anything about my favorite player. But I just wanted to keep it short. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Comment, like, subscribe, and share.